lesson 12.
Did you know
lesson 12? To leave somebody righteously in this special world. Lesson 13. So you are reaping. Memory fast. Give and it shall be given unto you.
Praise the Lord! Among you parents, who can tell us the memory verse of last year to this day? Can you? Put your hands together for them again. Now they want to give us Genesis to Revelation.
Confess that I was dazed by that sensational recitation and all the recitations. And I hope the Lord will bless his children in Jesus' name. Okay, we go to the next program on agenda now. We have drama songs to be coordinated by Sister Akinyemi. And after that, the children's mass choir will come up to be coordinated by Sister Julius. Please, let's do this very fast because our time is on our side. Thank you. God bless us.
Oh, duro reti wa ni le mi mo to dara Jesu duro reti wa ni le mi mo to dara ero ale bayi ke
gbere pe na sa
no jo sile no wa ma ka lo wa ma ka lo wa si e Jesu duro reti wa nile mi moto dara Jesu duro reti wa nile mi moto dara
Praise the Lord. The meaning of our song, there are some saints that are going on a journey. Where some others are there looking at them because they saw the glorious crown they are wearing, they ask them, where are you going? And they're there to tell them, we are going because Christ is waiting for us. Is Christ waiting for you today? Because look at those ones with the glorious crowns and they have a staff in their hands. You too, Christ is waiting for you today. He's waiting there for you to join him in that kingdom. I pray you and me will be counted worthy at the hand in Jesus' name.
Let's pray together for them. All right, we move on now. Now we are in another section where Tuchiro will recite Yoruba hymns for us, and they are Dokas Akinola and the Olorunfemi Grace. Can you please come up as you give your Yoruba hymns? Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord! Jehovah!
Hallelujah!
My name is Akela Dokas. With me here is...
Welcome to your show.
We are here to present a song titled Efi Ifoluwa, which is taken from hymn 66. And I pray as you listen, the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Olurabadawa fun wa o te je come available.
Praise the Lord. Let's pray together for them. Okay. Now, the only reason why we say that you shouldn't clap for any of these children is when you can do what they've done. But since nobody yet, I can't do it, I must confess to us. Since I can't do it, I have to put my hands together. Let's put them together for them once again. Okay. We are now into another section where we have our children coming up to sing. It was time for children, mass, choir to be coordinated by Sister Julius. Let's hear them sing. Na, 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 na. All of them.
Thank you. abẹ́ kùyà jẹ́jọ́. We are wonderful in me. We are special in the hands of God. We are wonderful in me. We are wonderful in me. We are wonderful in me. We are special in the hands of God. We are wonderful in me. We are better than treasure.
Special numbers, and I want these children to come out. Akinola Dokas, Gloria Deniro, and John, please come out for your special number one after the other. Where are they? Dokas.
Praise the Lord. Praise, praise, praise the living Jesus. My name is Akela Dokas. I am here to present a song titled "By Emu," and I pray as a listener that the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Bye.
Please, let's pray together for her. Let's do it with all of our hearts. Okay, go. Please, let's welcome the next person.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. My name is Adeniran Glory. I'm here to sing a song. Be like Jesus every day in your life. Be like Jesus every day in your life. Be like Jesus in his beauty. Be like Jesus every day. Every day. Be like Jesus.
Let's put her together for her. Let's put her hand together for her. She has done well. Alright, we're very sorry for John. He was shy. And so we need to call that chapter a close. Now, this is that section where we have the orchestra. Are you ready? Or we move to the next section? Okay, let's put her together for them. Let's put her hand together for them. Thank you. that is not enough for that wonderful, sensational rendition, please. Thank you. God bless you. Now we're going to the next section, that is discourse, and I want the following children to get ready, youth. Ola Toyosi Mofinfoluwa, and the Arugundade Olayemi, and then Adeniran or Gabriel, also David, also Odun Ayo. Let's get ready for our discourse. Mommy Julius, you can take over from there.
Good day, mommies and daddy. We are from the children's department. We are here to recite 6 lessons from our last Sunday school pamphlet with their memory verses. As you listen, may God bless you. Lesson 1.
God test Israel. Examine me, O Lord. Approve me. Try my heart and my heart.
Psalm 26, verse 2. Lesson 2. Deborah and Barak obey God. And Deborah said unto Barak, oh, for this is the day in which the Lord has delivered Sisera into the hand. Judges 4:14. Lesson 3. Deborah and Barak obey God. Let everything that happened.
Praise the Lord. Praise in the Lord. Psalm 18, verse 6. Lesson
4. God sent Gideon
to deliver Israel, and he said unto them, go into all the world, and preach the gospel to every creature.
Mark 16, verse 15. Lesson 5.
Gideon prepare Israel for war, but it has faith. It is impossible to place him. It was 11, verse 6.
Lesson 6.
How to say to Korea and my friend of Jesus, let brotherly love continue. It was 13, verse 1.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. My name is Deborah Amolewa. I'm here to recite my memory verse, which is taken from the book of 2 Timothy 2, verse 15. I'm a champion. I study to show myself approved unto God. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. My name is Akela Dokas. I'm here to recite my memory verse, which is taken from John 8, verse 12. I am born to shine. I am a light to my generation. And the second memory verse which I'm going to say is taken from Revelation 1 verses. I am a royal priesthood, chosen to make a difference in my world. Thank you.
Good day, mommies and daddies. My name is Akemi Deborah. Here with me is
Afolabin Yoluwa.
We are here to recite the memory verse and the topic of our last pamphlet. God bless you as you listen. Lesson 1.
God proves Israel.
And the text is taken from
Judges chapter 3, verse 4.
And he said, and they were to prove Israel by them, to know whether they were walking unto the commandment of the Lord, which he commanded their father by the hands of Moses. Lesson 2.
The split of Deborah and Barak.
And the text is taken from
Judges chapter 4, verse 14.
And it says,
and Deborah said unto Barak,
oh, for this is the day in which the Lord has delivered Sisera into the hand. Is not the Lord gone out before thee? Lesson 3.
So Barak went down from Mount Tabor
and 10,000 men after him. Lesson 3.
Deborah and Barak's song of victory.
And the text is taken from
Judges chapter 5, verse 1 and 2.
And it says, then sang Deborah and Barak, the son of Abinoam, on that they say, praise the Lord for the avenging of Israel, when the people willingly offer themselves. Lesson 4.
Gideon, God commissions Gideon.
And the text is taken from
Judges chapter 6, verse 14.
And he said, that the Lord looked upon him and said, go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the hands of the Midianites. Have not I sent thee? Lesson 5.
Gideon prepares Israel for war.
And the text is taken from
Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6.
And he said,
but without faith it is impossible to please God. For him that cometh unto God must believe that he is, and is the rewarder of those that diligently seek him.
Lesson six.
Settlement of dispute among believers.
And the text is taken from
Psalm 133 verse 1.
And it says, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Lesson 7.
Keeping your body holy.
And the text is taken from
1 Corinthians 6 verse 20.
And it says, for we were bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God. Lesson 8.
Biblical pattern of marriage.
And the text is taken from
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 1 and 2.
And it said, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and your mother, for this is the first commandment which promise. Lesson 9.
Limit to Christian freedom.
And the text is taken from
Colossians chapter 3 verse 17.
And it says, and whatsoever you do in words or deeds, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Lesson 10.
Paul exemplary life in ministry.
And the text is taken from
1 Timothy 4 verse 12.
And it says, let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. Lesson 11.
The Lord's Supper.
And the text is taken from
1 Corinthians 11. Chapter 11 verse 26.
And it says, for as often as ye eat this bread and drink this cup, you do shew the Lord's death till he comes. Lesson 12.
Bible way of living godly.
And the text is taken from
Titus 2 verse 12.
And it says, teaching us that denying of godliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. Lesson 13, which is the last lesson.
Sowing and reaping.
And the text is taken from
Luke 6 verse 38.
And it said, give and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men give unto their bosom. For with the same measure that ye met with them, shall be measured unto you again.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay, let's pray together for them. Let's put the hand together for them. Let's do it again. Let's pray together for them. They've really tried. Okay. Now it's time for discourse now. Sister Julius, are they ready? They are ready. Okay. The first person here is Ola Toyosi Mufiyi Foluwa. If it's not, let's have Arugundade Olayemi. Okay, come up. Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord. Praise Master Jesus. My name is Adino Gabriel. I'm Tiyao Olatoich. Arugundade Olayemi. We are here to talk about what is called discourse on how to set standard for your children. Show me a society, organization, or family where there is no set of moral standard. I will show you of a society, organization, or family where auntie is the order of the day. Setting standard and acceptable behaviors is important in maintaining law and order, peaceful coexistence among people, and for smoothly running of human organization, be it country, organization, or family. Yeah, our main focus on set standard in the family circle, Genesis 4 verse 1, 25-29. Children are gift from God, is no need to claim Christian parents. If you know that Christian are gift from God, then we Christian parents acknowledge this gift from him. Then we must nurture our children in his fear and admonitions. One of these standards is that the standards are limited. That included the instant fellowship with God. A flashback of the first man and woman in the Garden of Eden gives insight into that. In the Garden of Eden, God provided everything for the first man and woman needed for their spiritual, social, and physical growth, survival. But did he set standard for them? Yes. One of the standards is that they should not eat from the fruit of the forbidden tree. As soon as they fulfilled God's commandment, they were made to suffer the consequences of their action. The tax of raising children, especially godly ones, is no mean tax. It is a tax that should be taken on with both parents, especially mothers, with much devotion and commitment. We must have read authors and as well receive counsels that we should love our children unreservedly.
Many parents fail to enforce discipline to their children because they feel it is cruel. Their love for their children constrains them from disciplining them when necessary. This is not according to God's words. In God's word, he says clearly in Proverbs 3 verse 12, in whom the Lord loveth he correcteth, not as his father is his son, in whom delighteth. He must set standard for children who are goodly, godly, care in mind. He must set standard for children who from your digitals grow from little to six, 3 to 6. They develop an inquisitive mind. An inquisitive child is fun to raise and at the same time pain on the neck. It may sometimes difficult when the question answers when you ought to do another thing.
Building the inquisitiveness in your thoughts. Parents should want inquisitive children. Inquisitiveness or curiosity bothers the child mind, and the bother mind helps in the holistic development of the child. An inquisitive child is always actively seeking answers. This inquisitiveness propels him towards unraveling the mystery of daily life. Inquisitiveness fosters a feeling of learning, which can prove to be a great help in the child's future. It makes him a good disruptor, capable of grasping new concepts easily. Thus, he has the child's potential for learning. An inquisitive child is the one that typically participates in school and understands more concepts because his question has been answered. Many times, learning the subject in class isn't enough. It is more important to go above and beyond by asking the right question. The process of going above and beyond is what makes him be an A student. Parents may often feel irritated by asking the numerous questions their child posed to them. But it is necessary to understand that for a child, everything around him is new, exciting. The latent inquisitiveness of the child leaves him awestruck at almost everything he looks at. Physical activity stimulates the inquisitiveness in him. And since he is naturally curious about his surroundings and explores his environment mostly by playing. In fact, the latest medical trend, the child development, encourages parents to foster the sense of inquisitiveness among their kids. A child's inquisitiveness will never be suppressed. Otherwise, it may add advancing part of his early development. You should rather encourage inquisitiveness in your thought and watch him grow into a knowledgeable and mature individual. The following ideas help in terms of building a child's inquisitiveness. 1. Model behavior at home. First, start statement with, what does the Bible say? What would happen if modeling this behavior over time will likely be repeated by the child whenever he has a question or problem? Hence, you must always repeat it for the child to pick up. 2. Make conscious effort to find answer to the child's question. You should be ready to answer his question and tell him nothing but the truth. Never be bored by his question or inquiries. Never put him off, otherwise he may get his answer from elsewhere, especially from ungodly adults. Read books, surf the internet, or look up what's in the dictionary if you have to, in order to answer the child's question. 3. Games and any other activity are perhaps the best way you can inculcate inquisitiveness among them. He's basically inquisitive about his toys and belongings. Hence, he must always develop an interesting play activity that will help him satisfy his curiosity. Science tools are good tools used to develop curiosity in the thought brain. 4. You should encourage your child to express his natural surroundings. The external exploration paves the way through his prospection, which in turn inspired curiosity. 5. You should teach your child to find answer to his question. Capable of grasping new concepts. You should teach your child to be a good server, capable of grasping new concepts easily. You should also help to improve intention span. 5. Your high level of attention to your child will likely be repeated by the child whenever he has a question or problem. You should help your child be inquisitive. Will be a lot of work and time consuming if he isn't naturally inclined. Forcing the inquisitiveness in him is however, one of the most important things you must do as a parent. Don't suppress his inquisitiveness. Answer his question and lead him to Christ.
Understanding the character traits of a young child, ages 6 to 10 years. Between ages 6 and 8, your child has a lot of energy. He learns to control his body and enjoy manipulating objects. He finds that the object or perform five motor task challenging. Cognitively, he learns best by instruction. Instruction passed to him to be very few and simple. Besides, he has a limited attention span and is easily distracted by his environment. On a social level, he associates better with peers and likes to express himself sometimes. However, age 9 and 10 is when he really moves around the lot. At this stage, he moves around the lot and active. He enjoys dancing, singing, sports, and any other physically intense game. He plays until he's exhausted most times. His inquisitiveness has developed, so he enjoys learning new things. He becomes frustrated when he does not turn out as he expected. He attaches more importance to friendship and likes to express his like and dislike, sometimes vehemently, and attaches more and attachment importantly to friendship. From this tender age, 3 to 10, a little boy or girl may be very stubborn and weak and treat, wanting more attitude to do whatever pleases him. This is where parental discipline comes in. Children of today care for greater independence from their parents and freedom without any restraint. Hence, they develop an unfortunate propensity for being disobedient to their parents. Romans 1 verse 13. In the past, children grew up in a society that clearly defined what was right and wrong. Parents are recognized as the primary authority figure on their children's life. But the truth is, there is more talk of children's rights, of privacy and liberty in the school and in the media. Now, as the world confirms their children react to the unprecedented immorality in the school and in the media. So the Lord wanting attitude to do. For them, but foolishness is born in heart, but the word of correction has driven it away from him. Romans 22 verse 15. Thank you.
Setting reasonable standards for your children. So far we have established the fact that it is necessary for us to set standards for acceptable behaviors for our children. Standards that will guide them in their home, in their neighborhood, at school, in church, among strangers. Note, however, that the standard is set for your children should be to guide them, not to choke or cloak them. Children within the age of 3 to 10 are very adventurous. They want to explore possibilities. They want to explore the world around them. Ensure that the standard you set are not such that limit, intimidate, or make them feel less human and unloved. Therefore, in setting standards for your children, the following are useful suggestions to guide you. 1. Start early. You often hear some parents saying, "Leave him alone. He is but a child." Oh, you are smiling. You too have made that choice at some point. There is a tendency to postpone the discipline of that child to later time. But when is the appropriate time to begin instilling discipline in your child? Early is the time. As soon as the child can understand you, set standards for acceptable behaviors and make him know the limit they are. 2. Make set standards clear enough. Map out clearly what standard of proper behavior you want a child to maintain before he's old enough to understand you. Bear this in mind. Consciously cogate them your child. And when he's old enough to understand what it means to obey or disobey mom, it is best to discuss the standard with him and make him know what is required of him. Making standards that limits clear enough is very important, so that when punishment is being meted out of him, it will seem unfair to the child. Yes, when you discipline a child for an instruction he didn't clearly understand, he may feel the deliberate attempt to make him suffer for nothing. Be mindful of this. 3. Spell out consequences and make them stick. It's not enough to set standards. Also spell out consequences for breaking those standards. For instance, if you tell a child that the consequence for staying out later than the agreed time, your child grounded for the next 2 days, then let it stick. 4. Praise or punish. Praise your child for good behaviors and punish him for bad behaviors. Recognize good and acceptable behaviors your child exhibits. And as you do, let him know what the reward is for. And also, when he's being punished, make him know why he's being punished. And please ensure that the punishment isn't more than the offense committed. 5. Consistency is the key. If you punish your child for a particular misbehavior today and ignore it tomorrow, you train him into confession at first. Then if this becomes a trend, your child is made to believe that some bad behaviors are allowed. Then if this continues for a long time, it will be almost impossible to set the child straight. It is very important that there is consistency in disciplining a child. 6. Teach responsibilities. Teach your child to take responsibilities for his actions by demonstrating it to him. Children imitate a lot, and since they are their first role model, it is unlikely for them to take on some of the actions and behaviors. You must therefore make room for your child's exercise. In other words, you must be open, accommodating, loving, and understanding. Please know that these points are not in themselves exhaustive. One very important fact you must bear in mind as you set standards and ensure that the child lives by those standards is that you must not set unreasonable standards for your children. Most important of all that has been said is the fact, is that you cannot begin instilling discipline in your child without the help of the Holy Spirit. But of course, how can you seek from help from the one you don't know? It is very important for you to have a relationship with God, one that thrives. Only then can you order your child in the path of righteousness. Thank you.
Okay, let's rise together for them. They've really tried. That is a wonderful discourse. All right. Okay, now I want one of our parents to really tell us what he or she gained from that discourse. Anybody? I'm going to call on someone. Okay. The parent will tell us what he or she gained from that discourse. Daddy, can you please tell us what you get from that discourse, sir?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is a must for parents to be friendly with their family, their children. Because when you tutor them, they become your partner. Everything you do works along them. Everything they drink works along them, especially within their memory. And with this, a good society is created, a good family is created, a good church is created. So the most important aspect of it all is that let us make our children our friends. Once we make them our friends, then they have now become our partner in progress.
Thank you. We said we should make our children our friends and then we'll become partners in progress. Okay, let me add to it. There was a girl I was taking a private class, and I think the uncle of that girl was one time the deputy governor of Lagos State. And then after school, I will not mention the name of the school, after school, I would go there to take the girl. And I discovered that there was a boy that was coming from the same school. And the both of them just lock up somewhere. So at the time, and I called again, this guy will come to this place. What was he doing in this place? At the end of the day, I discovered that both of them were committing immorality in that house. The dad was not aware, the mom was not aware, but I was aware. What do you want me to do? Should I go to dad and say, Dad, this and this? But the man has promised that anytime this girl misbehaves, that he's going to shoot this girl. So what do you want me to do in that situation? The mom was not aware that this girl in the same house. But I did not tell any of them, because if I told the dad, that man would have killed that girl. So in that situation, it implies that most parents are not friendly to their children. That is why in their very nose, a boy will come to the house, commit immorality with their daughter, and that's the only daughter they have in the whole house. And then see what is happening. And the same thing is happening to many of us. But we don't know. We are not vigilant. But I was vigilant to discover that, because I looked at the boy, and I look at his trousers. I discovered that something was swelling up under. And I said, this woman must have done something. So I called the girl. So what is happening? She now told me, we're committing immorality in that house. So please, parents, let us be watchful. Let us be careful. And let us draw our children very close to us. And this will go a long way in helping us to solve their problems. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. All right, let's go to Earth Coach, and that will be taken care of by Sister Ade Oye. Are the students ready? Okay, Pastor said John will be headed or helped by the elder sister. Let's have them, let's see what they can give to us.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
My name is Gloria Deniron.
And my name is Jonah Deniron.
We are here to sing a song. Why do you delay? Come answer, Jesus. Why do you delay? Come answer, Jesus. Why do you delay?
Okay, thank you very much. Let's put that together for them. Well, it is not easy. Okay, John, thank you very much. Okay, let's go to the next section now. I hope Sister Adele Oye is ready. Sister Adele, please, let's have those children. What? Okay, yeah, Ed Talk to be handled by Olagojo Michael. Olagojo Michael, where are you? Okay, and Omolewa Jeremiah. Let's have Jeremiah on board now. Okay. Omolewa.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. My name is Omolewa Jeremiah, and here with me is... I'm here to talk about health. Parents, do you know that what you are eating can steal your healing? I will be seeking God for healing, but I haven't seen it manifest in your body. Christian nutrition might be what you need to open your door for God to restore you and make you whole. In your journey to receive your Christian nutrition, it is very easy to forget a very important fact. You are a spirit and you have a soul. That is your mind, your will, and your emotion, and you live in a body. In order to walk in true divine health, you have to consider every part of yourself. That is your spirit, your soul, and your body. Though it sounds very simple, but it's a fact so often overlooked. Healing is most successfully obtained when you fight for it in both spiritual and natural realm, which is the physical realm. Both spiritual and natural realm, which is the physical realm. Of course, learning how to fight for your healing in the spiritual realm is the most important. But Christian nutrition is the key for fighting for your blood, both right here in the natural realm. I once heard of a doctor named Don Colbert say something very profound. He was having a healing ministry and watched tons of sick Christians come up for healing. But over time, he noticed that some of them were coming over and over and again. They were not receiving their healing. When he sought God to find out why so many Christians were not receiving their healing, God began to show him something. After those Christians had finished praying for a touch from the Lord, he saw them outside the temple, eating and drinking things that were tearing down the temple of God, which is our body. Without their knowledge, they were undoing the very healing that God was working in their body. And yet, they had no idea why they were not receiving their restoration. Using his background as a medical doctor for the good of the kingdom, he teaches Christians the vital importance of what he calls the seven pillars of health. Number one, drinking water. Water is very essential to the body. The body contains about 75% of water. Water helps the joints to move freely, and it also helps the blood to move freely. Number two, getting sufficient sleep and rest. When we get sufficient sleep and rest, it reduces the aging process, and it also helps to boost the immune system. Those people that sleep for 9 hours instead of 7 hours, it is more advantageous to them because it helps to boost the immune system, which fights against diseases like bacteria and fungi. Number four, getting enough exercise. When you get enough exercise, it helps you to build strong bone and it makes you agile. Number four, getting sufficient, supplementing your food choices. You have to supplement on your food choices because when you eat anyhow, it can lead to diseases like diabetes, obesity. But we have to supplement on our food choices. We have to know the amount of carbohydrate we take, the amount of protein we take, and those classes of food. But as we know that too much of everything is not good. When we lack carbohydrates, it is not good. When we lack protein, and all those kinds of food is not good. When we lack protein, it can lead to kwashiorkor and etc. And number five, getting rid of toxins in our body. We have to get rid of toxins in our body. Anyway, this is a toxic world. But we have to get rid of toxins in our body by not inhaling harmful air, like smokes from gas and etc. We can wash away the toxins in our body by drinking enough filtered water. And number seven, dealing with stress. We have to deal with stress because when we overstress our brain, it can lead to diseases like insanity, hypertension. So that's why we need to reduce the stress. After implementing some of the biblically sound truths I learned from teaching, I could personally say that fighting for your healing in both realms makes a huge difference.
Some have been in our body through a constant of lack of needed rest and recreation. Others allow their body to be soft and flip, no exercise at all. Both groups need to learn godly self-control of their body. Too much food overchanges nature and turn more into disease than nourishment. This thought and digestion, which make the book serviceable and give health and vigor to the mind. Others in meat and drink cloud the mind, choke good affection. Some have visited their body through a constant of lack of needed rest and recreation. Others allow their body to be soft and flabby, which no exercise at all. Both groups need to learn godly self-control of their body. Too much food will attain this nature and turn more into disease and nourishment. This thought and dedication, which make the book self-stable and give it and gods to the mind. Others in meat and drink, cloud the mind, choke good affection, and provoke lust. Many man dig his own grave with his teeth. It is the duty of a Christian to take care of his body for a very purpose, that by soundness and well-being, he may be enabled to labor for the aid of those who are in want. Thus, the stronger member will serve the weaker member. You never get out of pot or pan anything fundamentally better than what went to it. It's the quantity of what went to it is the quantity of meal you get. Praise the Lord.
And we also need to eat living food. Well, there are difference between living food and dead food. Living food are those food that does not make us obese and does not lead us to diseases like kwashoko, diabetes, and etc. Indeed, living food are those food that make us not to be easily tired, because dead food are food that makes us to be easily tired, like junks like Coca-Cola, hamburger, and all those junk that we used to eat. It makes us to get easily tired when we are talking. So rather than we have to eat living food, that I mean good food. Thank you.
Let's dance together for them. Now, we want to go practical now. There's an issue here. Now, every day, and I want one of our mothers to answer this question. Every day, Monday to Friday, our children go to school with Bobo in the morning. On Monday, Bobo and Gala. On Tuesday, happy hour, and then cracker, biscuits, and all of that. Till Friday, how will these children control this consumption of sugar? Or what can we do? That's what I do in my house every day. Bobo to school, happy hour, Lugose bus, Rabina bus, everything. I want one of them to tell us, what do we do? And it's a must they go to school with all these things. Are we not killing them? Who can help us out? Okay, I'm going.
Praise the Lord. Early in the morning, the first thing we're supposed to give to our children before they leave for school, we're supposed to, even if a child doesn't like eating in the morning, they are. Thank you. They are supposed to be giving pap or tea. I mean, lift because contain powerful. I've forgotten the name. Beverage is for our children.
Hello.
Very, very good. Especially milk. They are good for our children. They don't like it at all. It's very good for them. Thank you.
Thank you very much. My question has not been answered. Should we stop giving them Bobo to school? Or what do we do? Okay.
Praise the Lord. Praise the mighty Jesus. Well, we can see that this particular issue that was raised is something that is now common and is becoming a global problem. Now we have children who are 5 years old that is having hypertension and diabetes. I have seen it myself. It is happening everywhere, and this is because of the changes, the transition we have in our diet. We can see all this in Bobo, they are just sugary, they are empty calories. They can't give these children anything. Let us prepare good food for them. Let us diversify the food. It is not until a child is as big as a balloon that you feel the child is healthy. The bigness has nothing to do with the state of the health of this child. Let us reduce these empty calories that we give our children. Especially we that we are working mothers, please, let's try and have time to give them what they actually need.
instead of giving them bobo, we can buy our local fruits, blend it together, and make something good. Chill it in our refrigerator, make it cool. We can make our home banana ice cream at home for them, and they will like it. I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Okay.
Praise the Lord. Our sister that answered most of what I wanted to say. And I just want to add to it that it's not every time you give it to them. As I do for my own children, I skip it at times. And I make a fruit, I give them fruits to school. At times I give them fruit to school. And in the morning, it's not always I give them heavy food to eat. At times I give them salad. I just give them boiled egg and tea. Just something light and not every time sugar.
Thank you. God bless you. So, on Monday, no bubble for my child and no happy hour. Okay. Thank you. God bless us. All right. Let's run together for our mommies. Okay. Let's go on now to presentation of names of God. Covenant Oye Nobi and then Elijah Orelese. I'm sorry for that pronunciation. Okay, let's have them here. Covenant, where are you?
No other names but names of Jesus. No other names but names of the Lord. No other names but names of Jesus. He's worthy of glory, he's worthy of honor, he's worthy of power and of praise. Good day, parents. Good day, parents. My name is Oyinibi Covenant.
My name is Oyinibi Elijah.
We're here to present the name of the Lord according to the books of the Bible.
In Old Testament, in Genesis, is Ram at Abraham's altar. In Exodus, is the Passover lamb. In Leviticus is the high priest. In Numbers is the cloud by day and pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy is the city of refuge. In Joshua is the scarlet thread out to Rehabundo. In Judges is our judge. In Ruth is our kinsman redeemer. In 1st and 2nd Samuel is our trusted prophet. In 1st and 2nd Kings is our reigning king. In 1st and 2nd Chronicles is our reigning king. In Ezra is our faithful scribe. In Nehemiah is the builder of everything that is broken. In Esther is Mordecai's faithful sister at the gate. In Job is the redeemer that ever liveth. In Psalm is my shepherd I shall not want. In Proverbs and Exodus is our wisdom. In Song of Solomon is our beautiful bridegroom. In Isaiah is our suffering servant. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, Jesus that is the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel is our wonderful four-faced man. In Daniel is the fourth man in the midst of fiery furnace. In Hosea is the love that's forever faithful. In Joel, he baptizes us with the Holy Spirit. In Amos, he's our body bearer. In Obadiah, he's our savior. In Jonah, he's the great foreign missionary that takes the word of God into all the world you go on. In Micah, he's our messenger with beautiful feet. In Nahum, he's our avenger. In Habakkuk, he's the watchman that is ever praying for a revival. In Zephaniah, is the Lord mighty to save. In Haggai, is the restorer of our lost heritage. In Zechariah, is our fountain. In Malachi, is the son of righteousness, coming with healing in his wings. Thank you.
According to the New Testament, in Matthew, Christ the son of the living God. In Mark, is our miracle worker. In Luke, is the son of man. In John, is the door by which every one of us must enter. In Acts, is the shining light that appears to saw on his way to Damascus. In Romans, is our justifier. In 1 Corinthians is our resurrection. In 2 Corinthians is our sin burial. In Galatians, he redeemed us from the law. In Ephesians is our searchable riches. In Philippians, he supplies our every need. In Colossians is the fullness of God's head body. In 1 and 2 Thessalonians is our soon coming king. In 1 and 2 Timothy is our mediator between God and man. In Titus is our blessed hope. In Philemon is a friend that sticks closer to us than a brother. In Hebrew, is the blood of everlasting covenant. In James, is the Lord that heals the sick. In 1st and 2nd Peter, is our chief shepherd. In 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, it is Jesus who has tenderness of love. In Jude, is the Lord coming with 10,000 saints. And in Revelation, lift up your eyes, church, for redemption right now is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the I am that I am, the Alpha and the Omega, the Prince of Peace, the Lion of Judah, the Ancient of Days,
our Redeemer, the unchangeable Trinity, the unmovable God, the unquestionable God, the unmovable God, the unquestionable God, the Ancient of Days, the mighty man in battle, the Lord that changeth not. Let's give him glory. Let's give him honor.
No other names but the names of Jesus. No other names but the names of the Lord. No other names but the names of Jesus. He's worthy of glory. He's worthy of honor. He's worthy of power and of praise.
Thank you.
Let's put our hands together for them. Okay. Let's go to the next section. Power of positive parenting. As I welcome Afolabi Shemilore and Akinola Dokas. Afolabi Shemilore, Akinola Dokas, come up for your presentation.
Jesus. My name is Akela Dokas. With me here is
Afolabi Shemilore.
We are here to present to you the power of parenting. For the Bible says in the book of Galatians 6 verse 7, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man sweareth, shall he also reap. If a child uses criticism, he shall learn to condemn.
If a child lives with hostility, he learns to fight.
If a child lives with ridicule, she learns to be shy.
If a child lives with shame, he learns to feel guilty.
If a child lives with tolerance, she learns to be patient.
If a child lives with encouragement, she learns confidence.
If a child lives with praise, she learns to appreciate.
If a child lives with fairness, she learns justice.
If a child lives with security, she learns to have faith.
If a child lives with approval, he learns to like himself.
If a child lives with acceptance and friendship,
she learns to find love in the world. Thank you.
Okay, let's put our hands together for them again. Now, let me quickly say this concerning what our children just recited about a family. You know, this man, he was looking for the son. So the son was outside by his car. So the boy was writing something on the windscreen of the dad's car. Dad was angry, now went to the boy, beat hell out of this guy, and this boy was hospitalized. The dad almost killed this boy. But dad now said, okay, let me go to my car and see what this boy had written in there. When this man got to the car, what he read there was, Daddy, I love you. The man committed suicide immediately. So it implies that our children love us, and then we should handle them with care. And God bless us in Jesus' name. Okay, let's welcome Brother Taiwo for our salt drill. Let's pray together for him. So, Dre, let our children come up on time so they can have it.
Praise God. Please, if you are here and you are doing sword drill, can we kindly come out for sword drill? Let's come out here for sword drill. How many of us? Seven. Please. You are going to be number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven. Each point is 2 marks. And the rule is that if you have not gotten the verse, don't come out. If you have not gotten what? The verse. Until you get the verse, you can step out. If you have not gotten the verse, don't step out. Are you ready? Are you ready? Hold your sword. Let's open to Micah chapter 6, verse 8. We want to go. Micah chapter 6, verse 8. Micah.
No, oh people, the people, the Lord has told you what is good, and this is what he requires of you, to do what is right, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with your God.
Okay. Let's clap for him. It's Philemon. Hold your sword. Philemon, chapter 1, verse 6.
Bring the firstborn into the world, he says.
Philemon. Philemon.
Then the
hold your sword. Hold your sword. Ruth chapter 1, 16 to 17. Ruth, book of Ruth. Ruth chapter 1, 16 to 17.
Said, entreat me not to leave you.
Let's clap for him. Hold your sword. Jude chapter 1, verse 3. Jude chapter 1. Jude, book of Jude. Chapter 1, verse 3.
When I give all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that ye should earnestly contend for the faith which was once delivered unto the saints.
Hold your sword. Joel chapter 2, 25 to 26. Joel chapter 2, 25 to 26.
Swarming locust has eaten, the chlorine locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust. My great army, which I serve among you. And praise the name of the Lord your God.
Oh, please. Thank you. Thank you. Hold your sword. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 14.
People and holiness, without which no one will see the Lord.
Praise God. Hold your sword. Are you ready? Daniel chapter 9, verse 2. Daniel chapter 9, verse 2. Daniel chapter 9, verse 2.
In the first year of reign, I, Daniel, understood by book the numbers.
We have come to the end of this sword drill. We are free. At the end of this, we are going to present gift, both for the first. In this race, the first is Omolewa Elijah. And the second one is Grace Akinyemi. And the third one is Yeah, we have 5 and 6. Others can go. Let's leave 5 and 6. 1, 2, 3. 5 and 6, stay behind. Others can go. Others can go.
1, 2, 3, 5 and 6. Stay, 2 of you stay.
The reason is that two of them add 2 points. And we need first, second, and third. From the two of them now, I just need one person. Hold your sword. Are you ready? Open to Jonah, chapter 1, verse 5. Jonah. Jonah chapter 1 verse 5.
And every man cried out to his God, and threw the cargo that was in the ship unto the sea to lighten the load. But Jonah...
Praise God. We have come to the end of sword drill.
The Lord. So that is wonderful. I want to ask a question. Please, who can turn to the book of Jude, chapter 3, verse 1? See them, they are opening. See. So how many children do you have in the book of Jude? How many? Can you see? It's not easy. Okay. Thank you. Now let's go to another section. We have children choir to be coordinated by Pastor Ayodele. Pastor Ayodele, children choir. Praise the Lord. We've decided to skip some programs, but these children are just weeping down there that they've prepared, and then we don't want them to break. And let's just give her 1 minute to give us what she has in mind. Thank you.
Good day, parents. My name is Olorifemi Elizabeth. I'm here to recite my poem titled The Priceless Gift. You cannot profess to value Christ until you value him above all. You cannot confess to know Christ or to reflect his character before all. Christ doesn't just want to be present in you. He doesn't even want to be prominent. He wants to be preeminent. To be your Lord and all in all, life fully yielded to Christ is a life of blessed rest. Many great men have said many great things, but none except Christ could give this comforting assurance. A love that cannot be compared, a life that can never be destroyed, a righteousness that can never be tarnished, a peace that can never be understood, a rest that can never be disturbed, a joy that can never be diminished, a hope that can never be frustrated, a glory that can never be clouded, a light that can never be darkened, a purity that can never be defiled, a beauty that can never be marred, a wisdom that can never be baffled, a victory that can never be defeated, a storehouse that can never be exhausted. What a blessed assurance. Thank you.
Okay, let's put our hands together for Ariba Karangapeska. Let's put our hands together for she has tried. Come.
Good morning, mommy and daddies. My name is Ariba Kedebua, and I'm here to talk about the poem named Living Jesus. Children are God's gift, therefore they are precious and should be treated as such. Although God has given men many gifts, children stand out, distinct from them all. It is noted that of all earthly possessions, only children can be taken to heaven. It therefore means that special attention needs to be given to them and their upbringing, because they are living souls. The childhood age is the age of learning, so children need to be trained early and be handled tenderly and carefully. They are so fragile that anyone handling
can create an indelible stigma in their character. Be patient with them to do what grace alone can make them do. Provoke them not. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 4. Make them see why certain things should or should not be so. Endeavor to polish their judgment and work upon their reasons. Satisfy their curiosity when it is appropriate. Recognize their immediacy. Respect them too. Train them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Let them be brought up in the discipline of proper and compassionate. Let them be brought up in the knowledge of what God requires from them. Let assure them to fear sin. Inform them of their duties towards God. Do this always and interestingly, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto their children. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 7. Though children are the heritage of the Lord, since they are blessings from God, they should be valued and appreciated. Parents are enjoined to train up your child. Train up your child in the way it should go. Proverbs 22, verse 6. It is to prepare them for what they are designed for, and this preparation is to be done at the early stage. Good impression made upon them early remain as they get, they grow into adulthood. Bring them up to be responsible citizens of this nation. To this end, emphasis must be made on their formal education and as well as their spiritual education. Be sure not to endorse their education. Now, don't buy the dangerous psychological belief that advocates even a child to evolve their character in their own character. Remember, a child left to himself brings his parents to shame. Although they are blessings from God, they should not bear their light. They should be loved, not defiled. And the love should not overbear the world when they give us the earth. Remember the tragic story of Ella and his wayward children. 1 Samuel chapter 2, 12 to 36. Moreover, children learn easily from your own life example of godly living. James died by godly examples. Children perceive very fast, and they are aware of many things in their parents' life, even more than their parents can imagine. Practice what you teach them. It is a long way in determining their obedience. Don't let them observe any hypocrisy in you. Remember, God gave it to them, so you are responsible to them. And you must know that their training should not be done casually or left to others. It is an investment that is worth it now and eternity. Pause and think about this again. Your only earthly possession that will endure for eternity are your children. Be wise and ask God's teacher now to go about it, and he will teach you. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and lean on not in thy own understanding. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. In training up a child, parents should bear the following at the back of their mind. 1. Children are the heritage of the Lord, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. 2. Our children are watching our lives, and what we ask speaks louder than anything we can say. 3. Children are more in need of mothers than of cradles. 4. The best inheritance a parent can give to his child is a few minutes of his time each day. A child only educated at school is an uneducated child. His discipline was practiced on every home. Juvenile delinquency will be reduced 95%. A good parent is not momentarily afraid to be disliked by children during the acts of enforcing rules. Children are the sum of what parents contribute into their lives. The well-mannered child is the parent's best advertisement. Thank you.
All right, Pastor Odele, please, the children's choir. Can I please rise on my feet for the children's choir?
Thank you. Praise the Lord. Let's rise up for prayer. Let's close our eyes. He's Lord. He's Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He's Lord. Alleluia. Bringing us once again.
Thank you, Lord.
For making us alive. You're not liable to happen to us. May your name be highly exalted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, if you have millions of tongues, it's not enough to thank you. Father, your mercy, come and accept our little talks of thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, Lord, as we are going into your word, oh, Lord, voice out in Jesus' name. Father, I don't want to do it by flesh, but I want you to voice through me. Father, possess me in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, I commit the minds of people that I'm going to preach to you. Father, any stony heart, in your mercy, come and let them receive your word in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, I commit those who are looking for you for one thing or the other. Oh, Lord, you are the I am that I am. You are the one I can do all things. Oh Lord, your mercy, come and meet them at their points of need in Jesus' name. Father, I commit Nigeria into your able hands. Oh Lord, you are the owner of this country. Your mercy, Father, come and heal the wound of this country in Jesus' name. Father, come and forgive us our sins in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, once again, I welcome you to this gathering. Before I start, I would like to tell you a story. Time before, there was a man who boarded a plane to Port Harcourt. When he was entering, he prayed. During his time of prayer, he saw blood. Immediately, he alerted from the plane. Few hours later, it was announced on news that the plane crashed and no one survived. Brethren, I want to tell you the reason why this man was not among those who were supposed to be dead by now. It's because of his God's peculiar treasure. Let's open our Bible to Exodus 19, verse 1 to 8. Exodus 19, verse 1 to 8. I read. In the third month, when the children of Israel were gone forth out of the land of Egypt, the same day came they into the wilderness of Sinai. For they were departed from this, refused them, and were come to the desert of Sinai, and had pitched in the wilderness, and Israel camped before the mountain. And Moses went up unto God, and the Lord called unto him out of the mountain, saying, Thou art said to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel, ye have seen what I did unto the Egyptians, and how I bear you on eagle wings, and brought you unto myself. Now therefore, If you will obey my voice indeed, and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine. And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests and an holy nation. These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel. And Moses came and called for the elders of the people, and laid before their face all those words which the Lord commanded him. And all the people answered together,
and said, "All that the Lord had spoken, we will do." And Moses returned the words of the people unto the Lord. My brethren, when something is said to be peculiar, it means something distinct. It also means a chosen generation, a special people, God's favorite, or God's divine favorite. In this text we have just read, God had just delivered the children of Israel out of the hands of the Egyptians, and he made a covenant with them that if they obey him, he shall make them above all nations, which they reply in verse 8, that they will do all what he has spoken. Thank you, Jesus. Also, this privilege comes with responsibilities. For one to become God's own peculiar treasure, he or she must do the will of God. Let's open to our Bible to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 to 10, which says, "But ye are chosen generation, a royal priesthood, an holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should shew forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light." Verse 10, "Which in time past were not a people, but now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now had obtained mercy." From this passage above, Peter was informing the early Christians that they are God's special people, and they should try as possible to obey God and what it entails for them to do the will of God. A people belonging to God in a very special manner, who are especially preserved by God. Just as the Israelites are referred to as holy people, we children of God are also referred to as holy nation. The Israelites were specially chosen by God for a peculiar treasure. Also, Apostle Paul also called, according to the passage we just read, Apostle Peter called the Christians a chosen generation. Brethren, when we are called a peculiar treasure, we need to understand how we, children of God, are called his own peculiar treasure. Peculiar treasure because we were chosen in Christ Jesus before the foundation of the world. That is, before the beginning of the world, God, he knows us. We are brought with a price. The price is the blood of Jesus, which is shed on Calvary for the remission of our sins. As a peculiar treasure, we belong to God by his preservation. This means we must present our body as a holy and living sacrifice to him. We should not try and defile our body. As Apostle Paul preached that we are God's peculiar treasure, or even though from time to time we were not, but thank God for the remission, for the blood our Lord and personal Savior shed up for us for the remission of our sins. Beloved, I want to tell you that among his treasures, he has his own peculiar treasures among us. Among all the birds of the air, the eagle is God's favorite. That's why if you know more about the eagle, it's a precious bird among all birds. Among all the animals on earth, the lion is referred as to God's favorite. That's why our Lord and personal Savior is referred to as the lion of tribe of Judah. Among his disciples, John is referred to as his beloved. That is, John was the one he loved the most. Among his disciples, after Jesus was taken to heaven, Peter had the healing shadow healing the sick. Among the early deacons of the early church, Philip and Stephen were the shining stars. Although we know Nicanor and the rest, but Stephen and Philip were the ones shining among their contemporaries. Amen. My brethren, if you have read the Bible carefully, you will discover God also has his people. I will want to talk about men like Gideon, Elijah, David, Paul the Apostle, John the Beloved, Joshua, Moses, and so forth. Brethren, one distinguishing characteristic of those who are great in the things of God is prompt obedience, that is total obedience to the will of God, not going contrary to what he asks you not to do. To obey is to learn. This means obeying God in simple knowledge, holiness, and truth. Obedience requires sincerity, genuineness, and love. That is to back everything up, total submission to the Lord. It does not involve mere eye service. That is doing things in order to please man. It takes boldness for a child of God to obey the Lord in this world of perversion and upright poverty, outright corruption. It takes the courage to live holy and move against the tides of sin. If a man does not have courage, it is not easy for he or she to move against the tides of sin. A true Christian or a God's own peculiar treasure is one who is never ashamed to preach the gospel. According to our watchword, go into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Brothers and sisters, I want to ask you, when last have you preached the gospel to an unbeliever? A divine favorite of God speaks against sin and any form of immoralities, such as sinning, fighting, malice, clubbing, disobedience to parents, etc. A peculiar treasure fasts when others feast. Like example, Daniel of old, when others were eating the king's meal, he did not join them. He made himself an holy sacrifice to God, did not follow them. A peculiar child of God also relies on God's power. Like Abraham, when God asked him to go and sacrifice his son, it did not depend on his power, that since he has a son, it's his own power. Through his power, he was able to receive such a gift. Brethren, I also want to tell you benefits of being a peculiar treasure of God. You shall be blessed and have a transformed life. According to Deuteronomy 28, verse 1 to 14, you can find out. You shall have renewed strength. Day by day, your strength shall be renewed. You shall continue to grow in Christ. You shall have divine security. From my earlier story, if not of God's divine security on the man will have been dead. Above all, you shall be rewarded with eternal life and everlasting joy, which I pray every one of us listening to me shall have in Jesus' name. The Lord will grant you your heart's desires, because he is the rewarder of those who diligently seek him. The Lord shall meet your heart's desires at any particular period of time. Because you are God's own peculiar treasure, you will not be affected by these current afflictions which commonly affect people. You shall be distinct from others. When others are saying the economic situation is hard, you shall find it easy for you. Brethren, you may be asking, how can one become God's peculiar treasure? It is just easy. These are the solutions. One, you must surrender your life to Jesus Christ. That is, you must not surrender to your life in order for him to possess you. You must confess all no sins in your life, that is lying, stealing, and so forth. You must study the word of God day by day. Even in Joshua 1 verse 8 says, this book of the Lord shall not depart from your mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night. We will continue. You must be ready to be different from others. When people are busy discussing of things of no heavenly value, please keep distance. According to 2 Timothy 2 verse 28, we can find that. You must have intimate relationship with God. In Psalm 27, verse 4. That is, we must have cordial relationship with God at all facets of your life. That is, move closer to God in order for Him to move mightily in your life. You should win souls for Christ. Try as possible to win souls for Christ in order for others to enjoy what you are benefiting from Him. You must live a righteous life, faithful life, and a purified and a sanctified and holy life. Beloved, I want us to remember that according to Romans 8, verse 39, that none height, none depth, none anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord. You are different. You are peculiar. Lovely in God's sight. You are like no other. You are valued. God sees you. He knows you. He knows who you are. He knows where you are. Brethren, my question is that, are you God's peculiar treasure? If not, why don't you decide today to be more than a Christian? Decide today that you should become part of His own peculiar treasure. And I pray, may our Heavenly Father help us in Jesus' name. Let's rise up on our feet. Right now, let's meditate within us. Ask God to forgive every known sin in your life before we go further. In Jesus' name we pray. Right now, ask Him for the grace to be among His peculiar treasures. In Jesus' mighty name we prayed. In Jesus' name, Father, in the name of Jesus, Almighty Father, I thank you for what you've done. Because you have met the heart of men, Father, accept our prayers in the name of Jesus. Father, come and touch their life in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, among your treasures, make them peculiar in the name of Jesus. Father, from now henceforth, start a new thing in their life in Jesus' name. Father, those who are looking for you for the fruit of the womb, in your mercy, Father, come and give them in Jesus' name. Father, we commit all these children to your able hands. You are the owner of them. As the arrow is precious to the warrior, Father, they are as precious as to you. Oh Lord, come and guide and protect them in Jesus' name. We also commit our prayers into your able hands, Father, the grace and the enablement to continue training us, oh Lord, come and grant it unto them in Jesus' name. We don't want them to do it by flesh alone, Father. Divine wisdom and knowledge and understanding that you gave Solomon of old, Father, come and grant it unto them in Jesus' name. Have mercy on us in Jesus' name. Father, I commit this country into your able hands. Father, Nigeria is your own. Father, come and direct the affairs of this country in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, don't allow any evil disaster happen to us in this country in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, you know you can do all things. Father, any form of famine in this country, Father, your mercy, come and have mercy on us in Jesus' name. Have your way in this country in Jesus' name. Father, our leaders, we commit them into your able hands. Father, we come and give them a new heart in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, I commit those who are serving you in truth and in spirit. Father, more grace and enablement shall be their portion in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We thank God. It has been a lot of help us in today's anniversary.
Adupe lowo Olorun fun bi Olorun ti ran wa lowo loni ninu ajodun toni.
And in fact, in this year's anniversary.
Lotito o jeun to dara ni ti ajodun odun yi.
Last year God did wonders in our midst in this anniversary.
Ni odun ti o koja Olorun se opopolopo ise iyanu ninu ajodun wa.
And this year's anniversary, God did greater things.
Bakona ni ti ajodun odun yi o tun se ohun ti o lagbara julo.
And we really give glory to God.
A si fi ogo fun Olorun.
Let's rise on our feet.
E je ka dide duro.
For what God did in our midst today.
Fun ohun ti Olorun se ninu aye wa loni.
For what God did in the life of our children today.
Fun ohun ti Olorun se ninu aye awon omo wa loni.
Likewise, the Lord visit us.
Bakona ninu aye awon alejo.
We want to appreciate him.
A fe dupe lowo re.
Because it's a great thing.
Nitori pe o je ohun ti o tobi jojo.
There is no doubt we can see his hand, that is the hand of God upon our life.
Si ani ani a le ri owo Olorun lori aye awon omo wonyi.
What God did through these children is great.
Ohun ti Olorun se ninu aye won o tobi pupo.
Because you can see the hand of God upon them.
Nitori pe a le ri owo Olorun lori aye won.
It is God that has done it.
Olorun na ni o ti se eyi.
And therefore,
nitori na,
we want to appreciate him.
A fe fi emi mo riyan si.
And when we show appreciation unto him,
nigba ti a ba si dupe lowo re,
he will also do more in our life.
Bakan na yo se ju be lo si ninu aye wa.
In the life of our parents, likewise in the life of our children.
Ninu aye awon obi wa ati pelu ninu aye awon omo wa.
Let's appreciate him. Let's praise him.
E je ka dupe lowo re, ka fiyin fun.
Let's raise up our voice and thank him.
E je ka gbe ohun ope wa soke ki a dupe lowo re.
Because it's a great thing.
Nitori pe o je ohun ti o tobi pupo.
Let's appreciate it.
E je ka fi emi mo re wa.
Let's appreciate it. In Jesus' name we pray. Children,
Eyomo,
we want you to raise up your voice and appreciate God.
A fe ki e gbe ohun pa yin soke lati fi dupe lowo Olorun.
For giving you this day.
Pe o fun yin ni ojo oni yi.
He never allow any hindrances.
O ti le gba idiwo kankan laye.
No obstacle at all.
Ko si idiwo kankan.
Even what about the weather? He gave us a good weather, favorable weather.
Papa ni ti ojo ojo o tun fun wa ni ojo ojo to dara.
Never allow rain or sunshine to disturb.
Ko gba ki orun tabi ojo ko sise idiwo.
And we also appreciate him for relevant peace and tranquility in this community in Lagos State, likewise in Nigeria. No, there is nothing like riots or anything to hinder us or not to disturb us.
Bakan na adupe lowo Olorun fun alaafia ti onjoba ati ifokanbalẹ ni agbegbe wa ni ipinlẹ Eko ati ni orilede wa lapapo ko se ohun to n ja rogbodiyan tabi ohunkohun ko n se idena si aseyori ajodun odun yi.
Likewise, our parents.
Bakan na si awon obi wa.
God really help them.
Olorun ran won lowo lopolopo.
To help us, to sponsor us, and also to provide so many things in order to make this great anniversary a huge success.
Lati ri pe won ran wa lowo won ti wa leyin awon se agbateru wa ohun gbogbo ti a nilo na ni won fi fun wa lati mu ki ajojun odun yi ki o je aseyori.
Open your mouth and thank him very well.
Ela enu yin ki ebere si ni ma dupe lowo re.
Let's appreciate it. Let's
e je ka fi emi mo re wa
hun si. It is the Lord's doing.
Olorun gan ni o se yi.
It is the Lord's doing.
Oluwa ni o se yi.
And it's marvelous in our eyes.
O si je iyanu ni oju wa.
Let's appreciate it. Let's
e je ka dupe lowo re.
Children, open your mouth and appreciate him.
Eyin omo ela enu ke fi emi mo re yan si.
Let's bless him. Let's bless him.
E je ka fi ibukun fun.
It is a great thing.
O je ohun to tobi pupo.
Oro ka siri ku soko mi siri ku soko mi siri. Ra kuri ka siri ku soko mi siri. In Jesus' name we pray. We want us to believe. Because God is mightily present in our midst. There is no doubt about this at all. Throughout this anniversary from the beginning to the end, God moved wondrously in our midst. He did wonders. He laid hands upon many of us. And he has met with us in a mighty way. And therefore, we will not exercise unbelief by saying, God, bless me. If truly you are in this gathering, bless me. If truly you are the God of this anniversary, bless me. No, that is unbelief. Before we started, he has been here waiting for us. He has been here before. Even the past 3 days, he has been waiting. Because he is the God of this anniversary. He's not of God. It's not the work of man at all. And therefore, we do say, God, bless me, bless me. No. We want to appreciate him. All we need, all he expects from us as his children is to appreciate him for what he has done. When the service was going in different segments of the anniversary, of the service, God did wonders in our life, in our own life, likewise in the life of our parents. And therefore, let's appreciate it. Say, God, I thank and bless you for what you are doing in my life today, because I could see your hand in my life. I could see the unction, the anointing, and likewise, the blessings that I've received today. Do you believe that God has done wonders in your life?
In
our presentations,
God
did wonders. He has met with us. He moved wondrously. And therefore, he expects us to appreciate him for this. If you believe, if you believe that God has blessed you, God has met with you, open your mouth and begin to bless him. Let's appreciate
it.
For healing the sick. For saving the Lord. And also for bringing miracle to the needy. Even for the message of today. God share his mind with us. In all segments of this program. In all the segments of this In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Our Father, our God, we thank and bless you for this wonderful day. Oh, this day is a great day in our life. Even this year and the first year, you did wonders. You moved wonders even more than you did last year. And this day, we gather together. We open our mouth to appreciate you for what you've done. Lord, receive our time in the name of Jesus. Amen. Even the blessing that we receive today, in all the segments of the program, in all the presentation, we pray, O Lord, that the blessing that we receive shall be permanent in our life, in the life of our parents, likewise, the life of his, in the name of Jesus. The blessing that we receive shall be permanent in every facet of our life, in the name of Jesus. All these blessings begin to manifest. And we have no cause to regret, in the name of Jesus. Next year and the first year, if the Lord tarry, it shall be greater. In the name of Jesus. Even the blessing that shall upon us, this blessing will continue to multiply. And we shall begin to experience multiplication, multiple multiplication in every facet of our life, in the name of Jesus. The hand of God is upon us, and we will not miss it, we will not lose it, in the name of Jesus. We shall be going from strength to strength, from grace to grace, and from glory to glory, in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, thank you, Father, because you have done it. Thank you for increased faith. And we have no cause to fear in any way. Thank you, because you have done it. For in Jesus' mighty and precious name we pray. Amen.
We are blessed in Jesus' name. Hello, children, if you are blessed, clap for Jesus. All right. Well, the church authority wants to appreciate our children for great jobs they've done. And because of that, I'm going to call on Mommy Adegun for the presentation of gift. Mommy Adegun, can you please come up here for the presentation of gift? Thank you. Let's pray together for her.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We thank God for today. And the blessings we receive today, it is already permanent in Jesus' name. And all these are our children. They are going to be what God wants them to be in life in Jesus' name. They are another Samuel, another Omolewa, another Kumuyi, another Baba Kadelede. So shall it be, in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. We will start from surgery. Our children, they perform wonderfully. So I will call these children out now. And the person that we are bringing, the brother that are going to give them the gift is Brother Wole Agbaje. Brother Wole Agbaje. Praise the Lord. So I will call these children out now. Omena Emmanuel. Yes, Brother Agbaje. Wale Agbaje. Okay, he's coming. The second child is Akinyemi Grace. Akinyemi Grace. The third child is, which is first position, Omolewa Elijah.
Congratulations. Position. The second position, what's your name?
Iyemi Grace. Applause for her. And the first position, what's your name?
Elijah Omolewa.
Elijah Omolewa. Big round of applause for him. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. As many that are here today crying, asking God, where is my own Samuel? Write the date of today down. By this time of next year, where we are celebrating Children's Day, you will come here with your bouncing baby boy, bouncing baby girl. God has answered Pastor Benga. Is he alive? The same God will answer you in Jesus' name. And you are going to sing this song with me. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. Olorun a tun itan igbesi aye wa ko loruko Jesu si rere. So we have about 4 classes here. The first class is mercy class. The second class, grace class. And the third class is love class. While the fourth class is faith class. In the first class, which is mercy class, we have punctuality and active participation in class. That is the children that are doing very well in their class. We are going to call them out now. All of them, you are doing well. All of you are doing what? Well. And you will continue to do well in Jesus' name. So I will call this our mommy's out now. Mrs. Sarah Okewale, to come and present this gift to these wonderful children. Mrs. Sarah Okewale. Okewale. So, Eribake Deborah will come out now for punctuality and active participation in class. Which means we parents, we have a lot to do on our children. Let them come in time. At the same time, let's train them in the way of the Lord. Number two, Ini Oluwa Deborah. Ini Oluwa Deborah. Okay. Ini Oluwa, sorry. Okay, boy. Ini Oluwa for punctuality and active participation in class. And the third child. The third one is parental influence. You know which children we have, either negative or positive children on this, our children. But my prayer is our influence on them will be positive in Jesus' name. Because when they are making it, we will be happy. The first one is Eribake Deborah for punctuality and active participation in class. And in your group, yes, Eribake. Okay, praise the Lord. I move on to grace class. In grace class, we have two children here for punctuality and participation in class. Emmanuel Oluwaleye, Tofunmi Okunade.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Please, I just don't want to hand over this gift to these wonderful children. without saying one or two things. I bless the name of the Lord for what he has done today through these children. And with all due respect to our father and our mother in the Lord, I thank the church for giving me this wonderful privilege to give these fantastic gifts to these wonderful, indeed peculiar children, soldiers, anti-armies. I bless the name of the Lord. And of course, I want to thank God for their wonderful teachers. They have done a wonderful job. Like I always say, you cannot give what you don't have. What you see these children have done today is what the teachers have in them. This is an inspiration of the Holy Spirit. That is what you have seen today. And I must add this, please parents, I don't want you to see what the children have done today as a kind of entertainment. Please let's see it as a kind of inspiration, because indeed they have inspired me as a parent. I wish I could turn back the hands of the clock. What you have seen today, indeed, this is the example of the heritage of children of God, bringing your child up in the ways of the Lord. Honestly, these children are really, really loaded. Some of them are so loaded that they are in a hurry to dish out what they have, that they got cut off at the middle. I understand. I bless the name of the Lord because this church is still marching forward and keep remain standing. Indeed, it has passed through a lot of fire, storm, and is still standing. Why? Because God is in this place. And secondly, Christ is the pillar of this church. And lastly, I must say, I bless the name of the Lord once again for our father and mother in the Lord. For the undiluted truth of the word of God, he has continued to dish out to us, to preach to us. A man, I'm not trying to exalt him, but full of integrity. I bless the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. I hereby call on the first recipient in the name of... Master Tofumi Okunade.
Are you?
Praise the Lord. And also Emmanuel Oluwaleye for punctuality, active participation. Thank you. God bless you. Please, young lady, could you just come back here once again? God bless you.
Praise the Lord. We are moving forward. In mercy class, we have Inioluwa and Eribake Deborah for punctuality and active participation in class. Mrs. Olukomiya will now come out to present the gift to our wonderful children now. Mrs. Olukomiya, wherever she is, let her come out and present this gift to our wonderful children.
forward. In love class, we have children that are punctual and very active in class. They are Akinola Faithful and Akinbola Jijong. Akinola Faithful and Akinbola Jijong. For parents, parental influence as well, we have Olorunfemi, Grace Olorunfemi. Pastor Abaton will come out and present this wonderful gift to these wonderful children. Pastor Abaton, we are waiting for you, sir. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story. I can see the finger of God rewriting my story. Rewriting my story.
Praise the Lord. Today is a wonderful day, and I pray it shall be a blessed day to every family, the parent, in the name of Jesus. And right now, to present this gift to Akinbola Jijong. Akinola Faithful.
Is this girl?
Oh, how are you?
God bless you.
And I also pray for the children teacher. More grace to be able in the name of Jesus. This is grace, Olorunfemi, parental influence. Ito je ipa awon obi lori omo. Mo gbadura wipe enikankan wa loruko Jesu ipa wa lori omo ko ni bo sasan. And I give you to my daughter, Grace, Olorunfemi. God bless you in Jesus' name. Aha. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. God bless you, sir. Praise the Lord. We are marching forward. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. The last class, which is faith class. They are the children that are punctual and active very well in the class. They are Comfort, Olaniyi, Elijah, Omolewa. And the third child is Emmanuel Omenai for parental influence. Our mommy Sarah Olawale, Mama Apostle, will now come out to present the gift to these wonderful children. Also, Joel Amani and Agoro Ayomide for parental influence as well. It means their parents are working on them very well. That's the reason why this gift will be given to them. Agoro Ayomide and Joel Amani. They too should come and join them.
Welcome to Christ Apostolic Church. Enter Apostolic Ministries.
Akiwa kaabo si ijo apostolic ti Christi, ise iranse ti apostolic ti igba ikeyin.
Where holiness and righteousness is our watchword.
Nibiti iwa mimo ati ododo je akomona wa.
Our weekly programs are as follows.
Awon eto ariose wa ni wonyi.
Every Thursday of the week is our interdenominational revival our program.
Gbogbo ojo bo ni ipade wakati sojito la gbogbo ijo koja,
which comes up between the hours of 7:30 a.m. and 10 a.m. in the morning.
To ma waye ni agogo meje abo si ago mewa owuro.
In the evening of the same Thursday is our enriching expository and systematic Bible study.
Ni role ojo bo na ni eko bibeli to fi ibukun foyeye ni,
which comes up between the hours of 5:30 p.m. and 8 a.m. in the morning.
Laarin agogo marun abo si ago mejo.
Every second Saturday of the month is our open heavens program.
O Saturday keji lososhu ni pade orun to shi,
which comes up between 7:30 a.m. and 10 a.m.
tin waye laarin ago meje abo si ago mewa owuro.
Again, every Sunday is a devotional service, which comes up between the hours of 8 p.m. and 11:30 a.m.
Ati gbogbo ojo isimi wa je ojo ijosin ti ma waye laarin agogo mejo si ago mewa.
This usually begins with Sunday school classes by 8 a.m.
ti ma bere pelu ile eko ojo isimi lago mejo.
You shall be richly blessed as you attend all these programs.
Aosi di alabukun fun bi a se nwa si gbogbo ipade wa.
Once again, thank you for coming and God bless.
Lekan si e se te wa, Olorun yo bukun fun wa.
Amen.